We'll now be speaking with Rear Admiral Hostilio Cornelio. He is the commander of the Philippine Coast Guard in NCR Central Luzon. Good afternoon, Rear Admiral Cornelio, and welcome to Dateline Philippines.
Yes, good afternoon.
Thanks for joining us now. Tell us about the continuation of rescue efforts in Rizal, or has this even reverted already to retrieval operations, if you will?
Yes, yesterday we reported that there are 40 survivors and 26 casualties. Out of the 26, we have 14 identified and 12 unidentified. As of this morning, among those casualties, we have 20 identified and 6 unidentified. But those 6 are already with their families. We're just getting the names of those 6 individuals that are considered casualties.
And are you still hopeful to find more survivors at this point?
We're hopeful that there are no more reports that are missing, because as of now we do not have the actual manifest of the boat, because apparently that's what the report that came to us is that upon training at the Coast Guard substation in Binoonan, they only declared 22, but when the captain went back to his vessel, people are trying to board the test,
Okay, so there is no manifest. We still don't know for a fact how many more are you looking for, at least based on reports and based on what the survivors are telling you. How many more exactly are you searching for at this time?
Well, we assume that there are more. That's the reason why we're still conducting the search and retrieval operation. That's the worst scenario. We assume that there are more. But hopefully, the final number would be 66, as reported yesterday.
Okay, now yesterday weather was a big factor. What are the challenges today? Is weather improving? Is it easier to look for these people right now?
Weather is improving. Actually, we are already here on site together with Governor Hinaren.
Okay, sir, what is your assessment of the incident? What went wrong here?
Well, obviously there are lapses from the operator and the owner. There's a intent to deceive us because they only submitted 22 in the manifest, as against the actual number of passengers. And we're also looking lapses of our personnel, the one that cleared the vessel.
Okay, we understand that there's a Coast Guard station there. What is their oversight in this incident?
Yes, there's a Coast Guard substation here. According to them, it was submitted only 22.
Okay, and there's an investigation for these individuals as well?
The investigation will commence right now because yesterday we concentrated more on the search and rescue operations.
Okay, meantime, what are your recommendations in that area?
Just be vigilant and then advise to the people here. Just follow what is the maximum passenger capacity. Once the Coast Guard has cleared the vessel, refrain from going up to the vessel just to, if they want to go home, they have to wait for another trip.
Okay, so the trips have resumed, I presume?
Yes. The trips were back to normal operation.
Okay, as regards the vessel involved, this is a company or is this a group or is this a business that owns many other vessels? We know for a fact that you have suspended the license of this vessel.
Individually owned. Obviously, the vessel is no longer operational.
Okay.
And currently, the operator is in custody of the PNP.
Okay, talk to us a bit about the investigation you're conducting, because Marina also has an investigation alongside. What do you expect to find out?
We are investigating the lapses of our personnel, the one that cleared the vessel, as well as the operator as to why they submitted only 22 in, as against the actual number of 66. So, I cannot give details as of now because the investigation is still ongoing.
Okay. Lastly, and on another matter, what update can you give us on the missing Coast Guard rescuers in Abulug, Cagayan?
I'm sorry, but that is not my AOR. Perhaps you can update you on that. Maybe later, but right now my area of concentration is in National Capital Region and Central Luzon.
All right. Lastly,
Northeastern Luzon, actually.
Lastly, also Rear Admiral Cornelio, Egay may be out, but weather conditions still call for caution. What is the prevailing advice to the sailing public in general, even in your AOR, including fishermen? Are there existing gale warnings still?
Right now, there are no existing warnings, no heavy weather announcement. And as I mentioned a while ago, the schedule of threat is back to normal operation.
All right. On that note, we thank you so much for joining us this afternoon, Rear Admiral Hortilio or Hostilio Cornelio of the Philippine Coast Guard. Good luck with your search efforts.
Thank you very much and good afternoon.
Have a good afternoon.